Good evening to all of you. Today let us discuss the second part of the vicarious liability. Vicarious liability of the state towards its public officers or towards its employees or towards the government servants. So please remember, before the common law in England, so actually there was a legal concept, rex non potest peccare, that means king can do no wrong. Of course, it was totally dismissed, and even according to the Crown Proceedings Act 1947, king is liable. And as far as India is concerned, Article 300 of the Constitution of India says the state can sue. The state can be sued. That means the state can file a suit against anybody, and anybody, any person can file a suit against the state. Of course, state means in the name of chief secretary or whatever department is concerned, like that, they can file the case. So the state is liable for the act done by employer. Why? Because of the relationship. Already I told you, vicarious liability is a liability which arises out of the relationship. Here, employee versus state. State means Article 12. So state means the legislature, the government, and the so-called government, all these persons, and also the organizations which are controlled by the state. Right. So two case laws let us discuss, because the time is very short. Very famous case law, celebrated case law, Peninsular and Oriental Steam Navigation Company versus Secretary State of State for India, Secretary of State for India, 1862. So Secretary of State is presently Cabinet Secretary, right? So what happened is, this happened in Kolkata. There was a dockyard called as Kidderpur Dockyard. So this Kidderpur Dockyard is famous for the preparation or preparation of the so-called, nowadays the garden research ship engineers is there. They are building the so-called ships there. So at that time they were building the steamers. So this the company servant or employee of this Peninsular and Oriental Oriental Steam Navigation Company, he was going in a horse-drawn cart, that means Gurra Bandlo, he is going, right? So in the Kidderpur dockyard, when these people were melting some iron piece for using for the steamer, suddenly that iron piece fell down from the upside, and its clang frightened the horses, clanged a bike for a sound. Iron kinda pannapudu bike run sound vastundi. The horses danced, the horses could not surge forward, ultimately the horses as well as this person were also injured. Then he filed a case against the government of India, right? So he filed a suit of damage because he was injured and his horses were also injured. So remember, they have taken the defense, the dockyard people, they have taken the defense. It was a sovereign function. Building the steamer for the purpose of India. But please remember, it's only an organization. It is a non-sovereign function. Pope said, none of our, the state is liable for paying compensation. Second case is State of Rajasthan versus Vidyavati, 1962. This is also another important case. You may not be able to hear that. Pretty bad sounds. Somebody has been elected as a so-called corporator or mayor. So they are like this. Anyway, now there is some. So State of Rajasthan versus Vidyavati, 1962 is another celebrated case. What happened is, here the collector's jeep, which has gone for some repairs in the mechanic shed, it was being taken back to the collector's bungalow by the driver Lokumal. So it happened on 11/2/1952. So while coming to the bungalow, what happened is, the husband of Vidyavati, somehow some accident took place and husband of Vidyavati died, right? Now Vidyavati filed a case of tort, that is for compensation, but the collector or the State of Rajasthan, they claimed that this was done in the discharge of official duty or sovereign function. But they did not agree. So it, the matter has come to different stages. Ultimately, Supreme Court stated that since he was left with the widow Vidyavati and a minor daughter, right? So for damages, the state is liable, even though they have wanted to go for appeal under order, that is Article 133, court did not agree. So it is not a sovereign function. Here the case also stated that if the collector was traveling in the jeep, you can assume at least that it is a sovereign function. Otherwise, it is not a sovereign function. No sovereign immunity. You have to pay. You are liable to pay compensation. So another case to say that the state is not liable. Of course, this case is deemed to be bad in law, but it was not overruled. It is there. So this is called as Kasturi Lal versus State of Uttar Pradesh, 1965. This Vijayawada case, 1965. This is Kasturi Lal. His name is very long name, Kasturi Lal Ramlila Jain, something like that. So he came down to Meerut in the Frontier Mail on particular date. I think this happened maybe in the year 1947. So, as usual, since he was a businessman dealing with the silver and gold, he was working in the jewelry bazaar, that means jewelry marts, and he was giving jewelry and taking some money from them. So, three police constables, they received information that he was dealing with unauthorizedly with these things. So they went there, they arrested him, they brought him to the police station, and they seized the gold as well as the silver also. Right? So they arrested him, sent him to the court, and the property, the gold jewels, they were entrusted to Muhammad Amir. Muhammad Amir, a constable in that Meerut police station, right? You know, in the year 1948, independence has come. This man has got independence, and he went back to Pakistan. While going away, he misappropriated, he had committed theft of this property and went away. Now, Kasturi Lal filed a case of tort to get back either his property, gold, or amount, I think 22,000 or so he has claimed. But the court held that since it was done in the discharge of sovereign function, discharge of official duty, because police have got a duty to keep the property in the Malkhana, they have done it. Of course, one of them may be a criminal, he has to be arrested, and it is the duty of the police to get back the ornaments, not the state. So, state is not liable. Of course, later so many cases developed and they stated that state is liable in such instances also. Anyway, as I already told you, it's a bad law, but it is not overruled. So, this case also, as students, you can file, you can write in this case also. Right? So, this case, I think this will be sufficient. Another song, I will discuss that. See, Ram Konda Reddy versus State of AP. This is Challa Ramakrishna and his brother. So his father Chinnap Reddy and some others, they were arrested by AUK police station people in crime number 18/77. They were lodged in sub jail Koyilkuntla. On that particularly, on the internet of 5/65/1977, around 3:30 a.m. The other group, directly to say, they have hurled bombs on cell number 7, with which Chinnap Reddy was killed. So Challa Ram Konda Reddy filed a case that it is a constitutional tort. That means the prison authorities have failed in the discharge of their duty. He wanted some compensation of 10 lakhs. Of course, the government, that is prison authorities, Home Department, they stated that they have taken all precautions, they have provided sufficient guard, they have provided sufficient lighting in and around the jail, but still some incident happened. For that, they should not be made accountable. But court did not agree, and ultimately, the state is liable for the laxity or for the act done by the servants and ordered 1,44,000 as a compensation. So here, they did not accept the doctrine of sovereign immunity. So please remember, these are the very good cases regarding the vicarious liability of a state towards employees. So please remember, definitely you will get one problem in this issue. You have to remember either all the four cases or at least three cases. Thank you.